There's a lot in this bill, and I believe much to be proud of. I rise to speak about the important initiatives that I'm particularly pleased to see included. First of all, Operation SNUG. As many of you know, SNUG, which is gun spelled backwards, is an anti-violence program which combats gang activity and violence in communities across the state. SNUG officials act as our eyes and ears on the front lines in neighborhoods hit hardest by street violence. They partner with law enforcement to interrupt violence by intervening in potentially violent situations and striving to calm the situation before it turns deadly. It's an innovative solution to a problem that needs a sustained and relentless focus. Sadly, gang activity has taken hold of our streets. Gunfire has torn through the homes and parks of our neighborhoods, and local families have had to endure the devastating consequences of death and destruction. And I believe that we believe enough is enough. God knows, I wish gangs and violence they bring weren't the problem, especially in cities like my hometown of Buffalo, New York. But the unfortunate reality is that they are, and we're witnessing it every single day. Homicides are up in the city of Buffalo and cities like Buffalo all across New York State and the nation. We can't pretend that this problem does not exist. We can't ignore it or wish it away, and there are too many lives at risk. The safety of our communities and the quality of life in our communities across New York State are at risk. By relaunching Operation SNUG, we'll cut down on gang activity, curb senseless violence in our streets, and make Buffalo and cities like it across our state safer. I wish to commend and thank all those involved for supporting this program, which I believe will save lives. If this budget accomplishes nothing else as it pertains to education, it increases our commitment to education. And what could be more important? Education is a stepping stone to success, and maintaining our commitment to students at our educational institutions is key to the future success of New York State. For years, we in Western New York have been fighting for fair and equitable funding for our schools. This year, the Buffalo Public Schools will see an increase of over $10 million. State aid climbs upward for all districts in the town of Cheektowaga, and Lackawanna schools will receive a 6.2% increase as well. These increases will help ensure that the students of Western New York are well educated and prepared for the jobs in the 21st century. But there's still more to do. School districts in cities like Buffalo need enhanced state support in order to provide the educational opportunities our children deserve. Every student in New York State deserves access to a high-quality education. The location of your home should not determine the educational opportunities presented to our children. Nelson Mandela once said, "Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world." Without the opportunities that a quality education provides, we're sentencing our children to a lifetime of hardship. The children of Western New York need our support, and as long as I'm the state senator, I'm going to fight to ensure they receive their fair share in our part of the state. This budget also includes important funding for SUNY Centers of Excellence. The Centers of Excellence are hyper-focused on specific fields of study and geared to lead the way in our innovation economy. In Western New York, we're privileged to have the Center of Excellence in Bioinformatics, and a second Center of Excellence in Life Sciences and Center of Material Informatics. The UB Center in Bioinformatics and Life Sciences is a hub of expertise and innovation in upstate New York. This collaborative effort is generating a groundbreaking research that is providing the health and well-being of people all over the world. Since 2001, the center has yielded 60 new life science firms and retained or created 5,000 jobs in Western New York. The Center of Materials Informatics will address the global shortage of advanced materials for new technologies in critical emerging industries. It'll accelerate the discovery of and commercialization of innovative new materials and give Western New York companies the competitive edge they need to thrive. The addition of $500,000 in funding will spur innovation, create jobs, and bring new business to Western New York. Also critical to growing our state's economy, strengthening our infrastructure and rebuilding our roads and bridges, enhancing transportation funding. As you know, I've been pushing for more fair and equitable distribution of state DOT dollars to Western New York, in particular Region 5, over the course of the last several years. I'm pleased that some large-scale transportation projects in Western New York were included in the 2013-14 Memorandum of Understanding, projects that will create jobs, improve public safety, and put people to work. Many of these projects are scheduled to begin this summer, which will hopefully make it a healthy construction season. While we will not stop fighting for full restoration of the $167 million, our region was shortchanged in 2008 and 2009. We're hopeful that New York Works Program and Strategic Transportation Enhancement Program will provide specific and significant funds for Western New York roads and bridges, in addition to this year's core funding. Our state must also ensure that Western New York receives its fair share of funding for our public transportation systems. The NFTA receives less state operation assistance per passenger trip or per revenue mile than the other major upstate agencies, despite being the state's second largest transit provider and the only upstate system with light rail service. We must address this issue moving forward. And in regards to OASIS, I believe this budget bill takes positive steps forward to help New Yorkers who are recovering or struggling with addiction. Many families don't know where to turn for treatment or what services are available to them when a loved one has fallen addicted. By improving the mechanism through which we refer families to these services, we can get our young people into treatment faster and ultimately save lives. This includes educating families in the recognition and intervention of opioid abuse and potential overdose. We must continue to support and improve drug prevention and education initiatives across the state. The OASIS budget includes a $42 million appropriation for chemical dependency prevention and treatment services. These funds are critically important for communities that have been hit hard by prescription drug addiction, especially in Western New York, where prescription drug abuse is sadly and unfortunately 70% higher than the state average, which is unfortunately and sadly too high as it pertains to the rest of the nation. Mr. President, I vote aye.